Dwarven crafts. Find dwarven crafts.
What can I get you, stranger?
Dwarven crafts. Find dwarven crafts.
The Mage's Collective thanks you. Make us smile upon you.
Magic exists to serve man and never to rule over.
Good to see you back. I've got complaints in the Nord Noble Tavern that some mercenaries have invaded. Nothing violent has happened. The sellswords are probably just disturbing the nobles' rarefied conversation. Just drum the louts out of there. The barkeep doesn't mind some blood, or sport, as she called it. Captain said Denerim won't miss a few dead mercenaries. Do what you will, and good luck.
Very well. looking at. We're the Crimson Oars. Oh, you're threatening us. We're veterans of many battles. Who are you? Then it's time for a bit of exercise.
Wipe them out!
Okay, go with you now.
So be it.
Looking at. We're the Crimson Oars. Oh.
It's either you or me, and it isn't going to be me.
Make us blessings upon you, Warden.
Good job clearing those louts out.
Edwina sends her thanks for getting rid of the Crimson Oars. She got her sport and she's as pleased as a swine in mud. Here's payment. You've helped out a great deal. Thanks for the help you've given. Unfortunately, I have more headaches to deal with. Thanks for the help you've given.
I have more headaches to deal with.
Questions, are you? Well, that depends, does it not? What does she seem to be? Sometimes I do wonder the very same thing. Tell me, how much do you know of the tale? The one that the chastened still tell of my mother, to frighten them into obedience. I see. That does explain much. I can relay what Flemeth once told me herself, and you can decide whether or not 'tis the truth, if you desire. As the tale is sung by the bards, there was a time when Flemeth was young and beautiful, a fair lass in a land of barbarian men, the desire of any who saw her. Many centuries before this land was even named Ferelden, the tales say that Flemeth fell in love with Osen the Bard and fled the castle of her husband, the Dreadlord Conobar, and that he swore vengeance for her infidelity. In truth, my mother claims that 'twas Osen who was her husband, and Conobar the jealous lord who looked on from afar. Lord Conobar approached young Osen and offered him wealth and power in exchange for his lovely wife. And Osen agreed. The life of a bard is a poor one, and love fades in the wake of hunger. 'Twas Flemeth who suggested the arrangement. All would have been well had Lord Conobar kept his end of the bargain. But he was a foul man who bargained with coin he did not possess. Osen was led off to a field and slain, left for dead. Flemeth spoke to the spirits and learned of the deed, and swore revenge. That was not the point. Conobar had no honor, so she would not have him. Flemeth begged the spirits to aid her, and 'twas they who slew Conobar. The demon the legend tells of came later. Lord Conobar's allies chased Flemeth, you see. Chased her to the wilds, and there she hid. There she found the demon, and he made her strong. The legends all speak of the great hero Cormac, he who defeated Flemeth and her great army when she invaded the lowlands centuries later. All lies. The truth of the matter is that there was never an invasion. As Flemeth tells it, the Chastened never raised an army under her banner, and she never fought with any warrior named Cormac. Cormac led a brutal civil war against his own people, and later claimed it was to vanquish evil that had taken root amongst the lords. Thus, he was hailed a hero. Flemeth was only attached to the legend much later. Perhaps 'twas due to the great war with the Chastened that eventually came, but Mother claims not to know how it began. Flemeth tells it with far more embellishment than I, but you are welcome. Dare I ask of your own mother? Few are abominations of legend, 'tis true, but I find myself curious nevertheless. Then you have my sympathies for what it is worth. Which is very little, I am certain. It matters not. Let us move on. We are in camp, so 'tis as good a time as any. What's this? 'Tis a rather odd discussion you seem to desire, leaning in so closely. Not unless you stop. Indeed.
Indeed.
Yes.
Of all their past and damnation.
Vashadin. Vashadin.
Indeed.
Yes.
Indeed.
Yes.
Water!
Defend!
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 As you wish.
Armed and dangerous. Ready for action. On.
This should be easy enough. This should be easy enough.
Only one shall stand.
Let's make this quick.
You had it coming.
This should be easy enough.
Defend yourself.
This should be easy enough.
Try not to look too incompetent. It's embarrassing. Let's end this.
Excellent.
On.
Less fighting, more dying, blast you!
Indeed.
Yes.
Here they come.
Yes, yes.
Indeed.
Yes. What is that smell? You ever wonder why the mages built their tower out in the middle of Lake Cullinan? They have an aversion to practicality or something?
What business would the mighty Grey Wardens have with a man like me? Oh? What was this about? I worried this might happen. I hoped it wouldn't be you who came for me. I have no choice. Forgive me, Warden, but I cannot go back with you.
I've never seen one of you knife ears dressed like the King of Ferelden before. You made good for yourself, eh? Oh, I don't mean no offense. I know I shoot my mouth off. I'm just not used to your kind, trussed up all fancy. Oh, no doubt about it. You pointy ears look better in fancy clothes than us clumsy lugs. Oh, there I go again. I don't mean nothing by it. I swear I should start over. I'm mighty pleased to be making your acquaintance, sir. Don't hold your breath. No one's been allowed across the lake for days. I'm the ferryman. Leastwise, I used to be. Poor old Kester. Out of a job. Gregor just came down and said, "Don't you worry, Kester, we got it all under control, we do." Didn't say nothing else. And then he puts Carol in charge of my boat, Lissy, named for my grandmum she was. I told you, they didn't tell me nothing. And if I know they're mages, I'm better off keeping out of their business. If I had to guess, I'd guess it had to do with magic, but the Tower's always got something to do with magic. You go on ahead, then. They were nice talking to you.
On it. Right.
A little something extra. For friendship.
Let's get started.
Yes. Let me take a look. I feared this day would come.
Good day, and welcome to the Spoiled Princess. Is there something I can get for you? Of course. What would you like?
off. I was here first. Why, you looking to buy one? A Q what? Oh, them. But to tell the truth, this place was mostly pit clean when I got here. I got part of a glove the wolves didn't chew too badly, though. I think it was a glove, anyway. I know, don't say it. I got cheated. I knew the guy who was here before me. He sold me this spot. Said he found giants and all kind of crazy valuables. He didn't mention that he'd taken everything but the bones and the dirt already. His name's Ferrin. Squirrely little bastard, if you ask me. Which you didn't, but I said it anyway. He was going to Orzammar, he said. I imagine he's gotten there by now. If you find him, tell him I sent you. It'll scare the piss out of him. Ah.
Rough travels out here, eh? We even saw Darkspawn on the way in. We're delivering a message to the Chantry in Denerim. You? I thought you said... Wait, you're serious? I suppose that's all right. As long as it gets there. Stay safe.
I see.
the Darkspawn are fleeing the underground, and we are going there.
I shall do it.
Step right, make us breath. Oh, beg your pardon, friend, you, startled me a bit. Can what? I'm sorry, I don't know what that...
Where is my sword?
I don't know what you mean, sir. I don't have it, I swear by Andraste's knickers. I sold it on the way here. It's true. Maker, please, you have to believe me. If I had it, I'd give it to you. I sold it to a dwarf in Redcliffe, name of Dwin. I don't rightly know. He said he was a collector. It's none of my business what a person wants with my merchandise once it's changed hands.
We'll see.
Did you see the new recruiter?
Were you really in that cage for 20 days?
It might have been closer to 30. I stopped counting after a while.
What did you do? I mean, 20 days is a long time to sit in one place and do nothing.
On good days, I posed riddles to the passers-by, offering them treasures in exchange for correct answers.
Really?
No.
Ah, too bad. That's got serious potential.
My goods are just rotting on their doorstep. I won't just stand here and take this.
Oh, you wish to talk to me? Truly, it's a courtesy for one so well-armed to notice a lowly merchant. Someone has to. Trade with other races can dry up. We surfacers are Orzammar's lifeline. Even if we're denied a cast, the Assembly says we've turned our back on the stone, but they still use the goods we bring. Hypocrites. Maybe it'll change by the time my children are grown. Twice a year, I'm confined to a trade stall in the commons, but I see enough. It's very closed in. My grandfather says I've lost my stone sense. I was born topside. I don't remember having it. Best of luck to you. Again, I'm flattered by your interest, great lord. Best of luck to you.
What can I do for you? This ought to be interesting. Such diction. This man is a true scholar and rhetorician. I am honored to be fired by one such as he. Good day.
They have to open the gate. My suppliers will think I cheated them.
Yes? Whatever you say. What business would the mighty Grey Wardens have with a man like me? Oh? What is this about? Oh, I see. Tauren must have sent you. I refuse to answer to a pawn of Tauren. Come, men! To arms!
Beware.
Injured.
another scar.
Very well.
Been out.
But I still don't have food to sell.
Excuse me?
Obviously you are no priestess, but shouldn't you be running a shop or a farm somewhere rather than fighting?
You think to tell me my place, Kunari? You are very brave.
It is not done.
But it is done. Do not be such a blind fool.
I speak the truth. It is not I who is blind.
Look around you then. You see women throughout this land, fighters and mages both.
That has yet to be proven.
Which, that they fight? Or that they are female?
Either.
So I am not truly a woman to you, hmm? 'Tis good to know.
Hello, friend. Care to take advantage of your discount? This way. And beware the urchins. They have grabby little hands.
And Eileen spoke unto the masses, my hearth is yours, my bread is yours, my life is yours. For all who walk in the sight of the Maker are one. Blessed are the peacekeepers, champions of the just.
I shall do it.
Yes? What can I do for you? I knew this time would come. I should have listened to my sister. Sure, sign the paper, she said. You'll enjoy some coin now, but they'll be back. I guess I'll see you on the front lines.
Let those who cry out from the shadow. Let those who have sinned.
That's an accurate life, Miss Alondraste. Maybe she was
so
ugly. Maybe she had buck teeth. How will we know?
An enduring perseverance.
On.
I am led to understand that the Canari have their own mages as well. Is this so?
You would not understand.
Not understand? Is it mental capacity that you believe I lack? Or are you worried I will sympathize with my so-called brethren?
Take your pick.
Is that supposed to make me angry?
It means I find myself wishing that your people held proper, civilized attitudes towards magic.
That is a rather hostile thing to say.
And yet you continue speaking. Astonishing.
You little... Oh, you're so funny. Such rapier wit. Your furry friend here took offense at me getting near his food. He snapped at me. Look. Sometimes I forget that he's a war dog. That'll teach me.
I must say that travelling with you has opened my eyes to how wrong some are about the Dalish. You are not at all savage, and I've not seen you snatch away women and children without provocation. No, of course not. I am just saying that many believe such awful things about the Dalish. If my people were more open to interacting with yours, we could do away with such misperceptions. I know humans and elves do not share a happy history, but peace must be possible. I hear many city folk talk about how wonderful it must be to live simpler lives, close to the earth. They could learn from the Dalish. how marvelous that must be. I have met very few elves, and those that I have met were pledged to the service of Orlesian nobles. Elven servants are well compensated for their services. Some of them live richer lives than humans. A well-trained elven servant is highly valued in Orle. They are nimble and dexterous, and many people find them pleasing to look at. I am sorry. I have offended and I did not mean to do so. That's a wonderful thought. I don't know what to say. Oh, how dear of you.
Anything I can do for you, please, please tell me. I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
Enchantment? Enchantment!
Your friends are formidable folk, indeed. It's good to have you along on the road. I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
Fine gift. You have my thanks.
Yes.
Indeed.
Indeed.
Allow me. I could do that for you.
A little something extra. For friendship.
I am ready.
As there is but one world, one life, one death, there is but one God, and He is our Maker. They are sinners who have given their love to false gods.
What? No mention of dessert? Surely this is a miracle.
On my way.
All men are the work of our Maker's hand, from the lowest slaves to the highest kings. Those who bring ham without provocation to the least little children are ready and cursed.
What is it? I have work to do. What does this say? I knew this would happen. Just when I was starting to get good. Well, thanks, I guess.
It's done. Allow me. I could do that for you.
Thank you.
As you like.
Dwarves, they're safe from all these darkspawn, I bet. Living underground, that's the way to go.
Yes, of course.